On one, off a bottle might be my tree. Smoking Agent Orange, high C. Back when me and Marty was recording on my mom.
So we need to pack up everything. By pack up everything, I mean unload everything. So that's what we're doing. So next time you see this, it's gonna be clean as a cucumber. Ready? Let's see if I can do this right. Ready, go! Did that work? So here it is, all cleaned up, all put away. Basically, I this is a secondary closet, but as you can see, it is storage for me. And what I did is I put like all my sweatshirts and hooded things over here, and then some jackets. But I'm actually gonna either get a jacket stand for the really ones that I wear the most, but I might actually hang some up. What I did, I actually took the door off this because the door like swung in here, so I would have to come in to close it to get to all this. But everything's kind of organized. I got like pants, shorts, tank tops over here. Over here I got my button downs. My brother's actually, he did convert me to the wooden hangers because these look like crap. So I actually have all new hangers coming in that are really gonna hold the shirts better in terms of their form, but actually look a lot nicer. Got my shoes up here, the ties that I don't ever wear, pants, some more stuff. This is all t-shirts. This is like all Abe Athletics, all Everford, all my casual shirts, and these are all my miscellaneous shorts and my like compression pants. Those are stuff I haven't opened yet. Got my all stuff up here, more shoes, bags. And in terms of, I don't know if I'm gonna put like a TV or something here, but again, this wall's not that big. Maybe you get like an area rug or something. Put a picture up right there. Bathroom's all put together. It's got a little storage right there. Ton of storage, actually. I can't use all this. And then the stand-up shower, which I really like. Put in my rain shower head, which is the best thing ever. Maybe I'll hang those up. I ordered some new towels, but got some speakers for the bathroom. But all in all, that's the room. I'm very, very excited about it. Very happy that everything's packed up or unpacked. And then if you want a little tour of the apartment here, so we have this is all the stuff in my apartment, basically. It worked really well in here. Got the sectional. This is probably gonna go because it doesn't really fit in here. It's just, we gotta figure out how to get this out. TV and everything. The island, the hallway. We have a closet over here, which is more storage. And that's where actually where I put the doors from in there. And kitchen, so very cool, very happy with this place. So I got my laptop here because I had to go over to my brother's girlfriend's place. They were over there. I had to go use the internet to upload the video for Saturday and Monday. There's the movie theater right there. Super close. It was really cool. It has like reclining leather Lazy Boys to sit in, which is very cool. Now I'm walking back home, which is about 3 blocks back home. And then a couple of my friends are actually coming up from Richmond to hang out, and then we're having some more people over the following night because it's a weekend. And I'm gonna wait until they get here to get some food, but I might take you guys along with me, or I might not. Probably not. See you later. What's also cool is there's my building right there. Wendy's. You can bet I'm gonna be going there a lot. So this is actually gonna make the most of y'all happy. This is gonna make you guys happy is the most. So again, building right across the street, apparently a really good sushi place called Sushi Rock. So we might try it out, see if it rocks. Let's try this. That is very good. It's a spicy salmon with avocado. I think I'll probably be spending a lot of my money. Instead of going to sushi after the gym, or Kroger after the gym, Do you get sushi like I did in Richmond? Sushi Rock for sure. One thing that I do find interesting is that a roll of sushi, it might just be at this place, so I guess even a Kroger, but a roll of sushi is the same price as a Chipotle burrito bowl. The amount of food difference is crazy. I guess you're paying for them to, you know, wrap it and do all the fancy schmancy stuff, but I think I'd still prefer a Chipotle meal for $8. So we are headed into the gym, and now I'm making some pre-workout and a BCAAs kind of concoction here, because, you know, with this being a new gym and a new kind of environment for me, I do have to measure in. So I obviously don't want to lug my gym bag like constantly around. By the way, I'm taking 2 scoops because I'm feeling crazy. Actually, 2 scoops a serving in this? Yes, it is. So I'm not being crazy at all. But I don't have to lug my gym equipment in every single time that I go to the gym there. So what I'm planning on doing is actually I'm going to, well, I'll find the locker. I'm going to get a gym locker there. I'm going to keep kind of the equipment that I don't necessarily need. Like that specialty stuff. So like my belt, like bench blocks, slingshot, wrist, well, maybe not wrist wraps. But I actually have a couple pairs. So wrist wraps, squat shoes, deadlift shoes. Because then I can just leave that stuff there and just take my camera in back and forth with me, because I actually can walk to the gym from work, so it wouldn't make much sense to drive or to metro home then metro back. It's weird that this is like my new thing, metro. But I could drive in today. We're gonna metro though. But, you know, I still gotta figure out the best method for all this stuff, but I'm learning, so you guys can just learn with me. Feels kind of weird, you know, being like, oh, I don't even know when I'm gonna drive you next. So we're like 5 minutes into this trip, and I can already tell lugging this gym bag around would suck so hard. So definitely a locker, and obviously the metro station on a Sunday. Nobody rides the metro on a Sunday. Why did I put my sunglasses back on? So this little app tells me where to go, and so I kind of learn everything. It says this departs 217. It's 217. No metro. So I guess it'll come soon. But as you can see, there's literally no one else here. Just metroing solo. Solo dolo like a cholo. So the gym is down that alleyway. And this is a CVS right here, obviously. And I'm gonna go in and grab a pre-workout snack. It's gonna be some sour gummy worms, because the CVS right here actually has like some of the most sour gummy worms in the world. Everyone's like, what's this guy filming? They don't understand yet. These are actually really, really sour. Really good. We're almost there. Okay, so I just paid for a year's membership, and I paid for a locker so I can leave this stuff in there. So this is gonna be the new gym, my new home, and this new chapter of my life. And I actually might also, again, get a membership at the Golds near my my apartment. I mean, it's gonna be kind of expensive to get both, but it'd be nice to have one super, super close. But I'd say 9 times out of 10, I'll be right here. So this gym does have actually a good amount of barbells, good amount of weights, some platforms. I was talking to some people, and they said that this floor kind of sinks down a little bit because it's, I guess, a little softer, and a lot of people slam the weights down. So doing deadlifts on this might not be the best because the weights are kind of sunk down. We got a chalk, there was a chalk in there, but very cool. This is like it on a Sunday. What is going on, guys? It is the first official workout here at the new gym. I don't know if I want to call this the official first workout, because, you know, it's not that heavy. I've been moving all week, and I have not lifted since Monday. We're into deadlifts, and you know, it's kind of taking a toll on me. I've been moving a lot of packages, a lot of boxes from the old place into the new place. It's crazy how much, like, how taxing it is moving. And you don't think you have that much stuff, and then you move and you're like, I got a lot of stuff. I can only imagine people who are actually movers for the job and have to move stuff all day. Extremely taxing on the body. But doing a push workout, so just do some bench press, some shoulders, and some triceps. I can only be in the gym for about an hour today, 45 minutes, because I need to get back home and do some more unpacking, package up some shirts. I don't have the internet right now, still. As of you seeing this video, I might have internet. But I have to, basically to mail out shirts to be ordered, I have to like get all my computer, get my laptop, get my printer, take it to the conference center, plug it all in, print it all there, get back to my apartment. It's kind of a process, but gotta do what you gotta do. Still gonna get in the gym a little bit. I haven't worked out since Monday. So next week, hopefully, will be the start of getting back on track, getting back in the groove of this new gym, but I'm excited. And yeah. So I've come to learn that one of two things happen when you take a couple days off. One, you come back and you're super strong. Like in the case of when I went to the beach and then I came back into 460-pound squat. You know, that's awesome. Took 4 days off of the gym and I come back from PR. Or you take, let's see, how many days? It's been about 5 days? Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Yeah, 5 days. 5 days off lifting and I come back and my workout's terrible. I'm exhausted. I'm just complaining in general, but I definitely don't want to get to the head. I think some people worry about it too much. You know, if you normally, let's say, bench like 275, okay, and you take some days off in the gym and you come back in and you bench like 250 and it's like super, super heavy and you're like, dang it, I lost all my strength. No, it'll come back. It's in hiding and you just gotta like wait until it comes out, say hello. But I'll be back in kind of the groove of things starting next week. You know, with it being a new gym and stuff, it'll still take a little bit of a time to adjust my programming. But should be fun. We'll be okay. Tell you guys what's super crazy is using machines again. I think the last time I've done reverse fly on a machine, I mean maybe like visiting a gym, but like it wasn't until my last school gym. It's gonna be interesting having all these options of accessory kind of isolation movements. It's cool. I missed like the rear delt machine. Love this machine. Love this. I'll probably see me be doing a lot of hamstring curls for my Ham Dog Millionaires. I prefer isolation movements for the hamstrings. Like machines, I like them. I'm not a big fan of like the quad extensions, but hamstring curls, for sure. I'll probably be using some of these hammer strength chest machines. And there's actually, I think, more machines upstairs, but I'll show you guys. You'll see as I see, because I've never seen it before. So this is actually on the fourth floor of this building. So there's like four floors. It's like some turf, kettlebells, a little bit of bands, some free weights, and then a little bit more machines and like the cardio equipment. But this gym has a lot to offer. It's crazy, it's like four floors. I think the deadlifts would like just crash through. So another thing that I have to get used to is timing out these metros. Because they come, like sometimes they come every like 4 minutes, sometimes they come every like 9 minutes. Now it's like every like 17 minutes. I'll have a little bit to wait. I'll probably watch a YouTube video on my phone. It's definitely gonna take some getting time to adjust it to this place. I keep like waking up every day and forgetting that I actually live here. It's crazy. Like I'm not like visiting the area anymore. I legitimately live here and getting adjusted to everything. You know, the metro, the bigger city, you know, things being more expensive, you know, just going to and from work and going to and from the gym is like completely different. Even though it's just a metro, it's like a whole new world to me. Whole new world. But it's exciting. You know, I'm excited. I think there's a lot of opportunities in the DC area that Richmond couldn't offer me. There's just you know, you never really know what's out there until you get out there, if that kind of makes sense. So it is a little scary. I'm not like, not terrified, but in terms of, you know, being in a different area is, it can be scary, you know, transitioning your whole life, even though it's only like an hour and a half away, it's a big deal. You know, it's, I don't know that many people up here, but it'd be cool.